Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at some useful things you can do with Google Search. So back in episode 833, I showed you some useful things you could do with Google Search. Now let's take a look at more and also some not so useful things. So let's start off with something useful. You ever need to make a phone call somewhere else in the world and you're not sure what time it is there? Well, Google can tell you that pretty quickly. So you just type in either the Google search box, or I always like to use just the box at the top there, and just type in time and a location, and you'll see the exact time right now in that spot. Now if you follow the stock market, you can also get a quick view of a stock's price by just typing the symbol. And you can see not only does it give you the price, but it gives you information like the volume and the market cap and a graph here that you can adjust, and also gives you company information here on the right. Now how about some math? You can graph things in Google by simply typing in a formula like say x divided by 2. And we're going to get this graph here, show us at the top. Not only that, but you can do multiple graphs. So x divided by 2, x divided by 3 with a comma in between them, and we'll see what's there. And you can do more complex things like x to the power of 3, and it'll give us that graph as well. Google can even do 3D graphs, but you can't do it in Safari at the moment. You got to do it in Chrome. So if you go to the Chrome browser and then you type a formula like square root of x squared plus y squared like that, we'll actually get a 3D graph, and we actually have animation controls where we can move it around or let it rotate, zoom in and out. So here's a strange one. You can get a timer in Google. And it'll give you this quick little timer here with a bar. You can stop it and start it again. And it'll even give you an alarm when it's done. Now here's something that actually relates to search. You could search for something and specify you want to know about it locally by just putting in, say, your zip code or city or anything like that. So for instance, I can type in pizza and then I can type in a zip code. And when I do that, I get this local search here at the top, complete with reviews and all sorts of things. Now, if you're interested in earthquakes, you can type in earthquake to Google and you'll get a list here of recent earthquakes. And it's kind of interesting to see how often earthquakes happen. Just about any time you type this in, you get some earthquakes around the world that have happened today. Now you probably know that Google lets you translate things. You can use translate.google.com for all sorts of stuff to translate an entire page or a piece of text. But if you want something really quick, you can just ask Google, like and you get a quick answer there at the top. Now you may know that you can define things in Google. So you can just type define and type a word and you get the definition. But there's a lot more useful things here. For instance, for a hard to pronounce word or a word where you debate how it's pronounced, you get a little speaker button here and you can listen.
Prerogative.
And also notice you get synonyms here for definitions. So you can use this as a thesaurus. Google can help you with area codes too. So if you get, say, a phone call and you're not sure where it's from, you can type just the area code, or you can put area code after it, and you can see you very quickly get the location of calls coming from that area code. Of course, that's not always accurate now that you can take your phone number with you on your mobile device. So 303 may be Denver, or maybe somebody that started their phone service in Denver. And while there's tons of useful stuff in Google, there's also just some silly stuff. For instance, you ever search for the word tilt? And another one is get a really bizarre result. You type in Zerg Rush and you get this little game, and you can actually play it, destroying these little guys here. Try to get your search results back. Also, ever notice that sometimes the Google logo at the top of the main Google page is completely different? It's some sort of cool graphic. Well, you can search for those. There's a website for them. Go to google.com/doodles. It'll bring up all the different doodles that Google's ever done, and you can search inside that. So for instance, remember that day that Google had a guitar for Les Paul's birthday? Well, you can bring that up and then you can still use it. So all those things are still there for you to find and have fun with. So I hope you found these Google search tricks useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.